We present Warhorse by Michael Morpurgo, in a version for radio by John Tams and Sally Ward, with Timothy Spall as the voice of Joey. The author's note is by Michael Morpurgo.
In the old school they use now for the village hall hangs a small, dusty painting of a horse. He stands a splendid red bay, with a remarkable white cross emblazoned on his forehead, and with four perfectly matched white socks. He looks wistfully out of the picture, his ears pricked forward, his head turned, as if he has just noticed us standing there. To many who glance casually, it is merely a tarnished old oil painting of some unknown horse by a competent but anonymous artist. But those who look more closely will see in fading black copperplate writing across the bottom of the bronze frame, Joey, painted by Captain James Nichols, autumn 1914.
Only remembered, only remembered, only remembered for what we have done. These shall pass onward when we are forgotten. Only remembered for what we have done.
My earliest memories are a confusion of hilly fields and dark, damp stables. But I remember well enough the day of the horse sale. The terror of it stayed with me all my life. I was not yet 6 months old. A leggy colt who had never been more than a few feet from his mother. We were parted that day in the terrible hubbub of the auction ring, and I was never to see her again. I was more difficult to dispose of. My buyer boasting.
That'll show you. Not bad for 3 guineas, is he?
The voice was harsh and thick with drink.
Not bad at all. Huh? Come on, you.
I was dragged along the lanes, tied on a short rope, so that every twist and turn wrenched at my neck. Eventually, we reached the farm that was to become my home. Two heads appeared at my stable door. One was that of a young boy, who looked at me for a long time before his face broke into a beaming smile.
Look at him, Mother. He's red almost. Red Bay you'd call him, wouldn't you? And that white cross down his nose is perfect. He will be a wonderful and brave horse. There won't be an horse to touch him, not in the whole of Devon.
Albert was about the same height as me and talked so gently as he approached that I was immediately calm.
We'll get on, you and I. I shall call you Joey, because it suits you. And don't worry, I'll look after you, and that's a true promise.
You should never talk to horses, Albert. They never understand. You're the stupid creatures. That's what your father says, and he's had horses all his life.
Father doesn't understand them, Ma. I think they frighten him. And anyway, when Father's drunk, he don't know what he's saying or what he's doing, and he's always drunk on market days.
Hey, that's enough of that, my lad. Bed.
Yes, Ma. Sweet dreams, Joey.
I went over to the door and watched Albert and his mother walking into the darkness. I knew then I'd found a friend for life. Through the hard winters and hazy summers that followed, Albert and I grew up together. And when he called me, I was there.
Come on, you on, Joey. Come on. Good boy.
Yep. We were now both strapping sons of the soil. As Albert made his true promise, it was he who cared for me and protected me all he could from his father. Albert's father was not a bad man, but when cider had been taken, his normal reticence deserted him, and a noisy waywardness set in until the sober light of day brought remorse and guilt. Market days and their consequences were a weekly problem for Albert and his mother. On one such autumn evening, about 2 years after I came to the farm, Albert was up in the village church ringing the bells. I must have been standing asleep when suddenly there was a light of a lantern at the stable door. I thought at first it might be Albert, but then I heard that unmistakable slurred market day voice.
So, my proud little devil, I've a bet on that I can have you ploughing inside a week. Farmer Easton and the others at the George think I can't handle you, but I'll show them. Now, we can do this the nice way or the nasty way. You give me trouble and I'll whip you till you bleed.
One look at the raised stick sent my heart thumping. Terrified, I knew I could not run, so I put my back to him.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.